Hey, what's up, everybody? So I don't know if you guys have heard, R. Kelly has actually put in an appeal for the decision on his bail denial. Now, I actually spoke about the whole bail thing. I have several videos that looks into the bail application or the bail motions for R. Kelly, as well as the statutes that involves granting a person on bail if that person is in R. Kelly's situation. So you should check those out. Those videos are on my page, right? So recently I came across this information on Twitter, and it basically is a notice of appeal, and this is in the Federal District of New York, right? I'm sorry, the Eastern District of New York. Yeah, so it's in federal court, Eastern District of New York. R. Kelly has several cases all over the place. There's two in Chicago, one in New York, and there's one potentially in, oh God, did I forget? I forget. Is it Minnesota? There's one potentially in Minnesota, don't quote me on that. And this particular situation is where he went before Judge Ann Donnelly, and she basically denied his bail. And I actually found the reason for denial of bail pretty interesting. I think it was wrong. I have a video where I discuss it with another blogger, Keisha T, Talking Loud with Keisha T. You can see that on my page. But in that video, we talk about whether or not R. Kelly should appeal the bail denial, right? So I'm kind of torn up about this, right? First off, I think the bail denial was wrong, but if you watched my other videos on the subject, you can see why they were able to do it. Right? And I'm not going to go into why the bail was denied, and I'm not going to go into the statute in this videos. I have other videos. You could go and check those video out. Those videos out. I'm sorry. I go into great detail as to why the or I go into great detail about the statute of the bail release, and then I go into great detail. I have a detailed conversation about Ann Connolly's Judge Ann Connolly's logic for denial of bail. But at the end of the day, I think it was wrong. But on the same hand, of course, I'm not a lawyer, and everything on this channel, everything in this video is non-legal information. I'm just, some guy on the internet talking out the side of my head. But if I were a lawyer in this fantasy world, if I were a lawyer, I would have approached the bail application of the bail motion in a totally different manner, because when you look at the statute, he has to overcome two things, right? One of the things he has to overcome is that he has to overcome the allegations that he's going to be witness tampering, or he's going to engage in witness tampering, tampering with the witness, harassing him, so on and so forth. And then he has to overcome the risk that the other people could be harmed by him, right? That's according to the statute. Not that I actually am saying that people were actually, harmed by him, but he has to overcome that. So the statute lays out the guidelines, right? So if I were his lawyer, I would have approached the bail motion in a totally different manner. So And I've already actually said over and over and over why I think this way and what I would have actually said. It's kind of funny because I said that he had to present a plan before the judge that the judge could deny, right? So part of that plan would involve probably staying in a secure facility where he checks in and he goes into that facility, when he's time when it's time for him to go to sleep, and then when he's out in the street, that he's escorted by some type of police agents, right? So that's not exactly my plan. That's not the way I worded it per se. It You can go back and you can watch my video with Keisha T, and then there's another video that I made where I basically introduced this notion of where he puts his plan before the judge. And my logic behind that is because you want to give the judge something that is undeniable. She can't deny it because you're presenting her with a plan that's so solid that it's going to look like she's not doing her job if she denies this plant, right? You know, so the reason I'm making this video now is because of this information that has recently come out. It actually, it's not recent. It came out a couple of days ago, but I'm just now getting around to making a video. But I was actually watching Netflix. I was watching Netflix, and I was watching the Epstein video series on Netflix. And I think in episode 3, they get into this thing where they talk about how Epstein was allowed to actually be on bail while, no, I'm sorry, Epstein was allowed to leave the prison, right? He was allowed to leave the prison while he had already been convicted of a crime. So he's convicted, or he has his deal where he admits to guilt of whatever crime it was, and then he's sentenced to like 18 months, but then part of the agreement is that he gets to leave jail on work release. So let's get into that. So here's the video that I was actually telling you guys about. So it's basically Jeffrey Epstein, Filthy Rich, Season 1, Episode 3, and it's called The Island. And basically, I'm not going to play the video because I don't want to get a copyright strike, but I'm going to basically explain some of the things that I was actually talking about R. Kelly should do. And it's kind of, I'm being a little creative, right? And first off, this is just kind of mind-blowing to me that I thought about this and this actually exists. Because when I thought about this concept of where he can actually leave the jail or be out on bail and he can hire government agents to basically watch over him and check in on him, I didn't know that that's something that actually existed. But apparently such a thing could be done, right? You know, so this is part of the agreement that Jeffrey Epstein made with the sheriffs in Florida, right? The Palm Beach County office, right? And basically it's an agreement whereby he's going to, here, let me just read some of this for you. The sheriff's office provides the opportunity for private citizens to contract additional law enforcement services with off-duty deputies or community service aides via extra duty permits office, right? And then it goes on. These services may include traffic control, crowd control, uniform security assignments, right? And other special events for private or public employer as approved and authorized by the sheriff, right? So we'll just stop right there because I think it the rest of this stuff, it gets on into stuff that's not relevant. But basically, I think what we're looking for is uniform security assignments. So part of his deal is that Epstein pays for the sheriffs to basically go out and be with him while he's not in prison, right? So he basically, here's the wage assignment. He's basically paying regularly $42 an hour. And then there's a premium pay of $57 an hour. I wonder what the difference is between regular and premium. I would imagine, and I'm just guessing here. I mean, it's a contract, you know, so it could be anything, right? So I'm just going to imagine a situation where, yeah, if it's average everyday regular, you know, coverage is probably going to be $42 an hour. But if it's a situation where it's probably a holiday or something like that, and the sheriff should be with his family or enjoying the holiday, then he's going to charge more. He's going to charge $57 an hour. I'm just guessing here, right? You know, so I don't actually know what the regular payment is and what the premium payment is, but I would imagine it's something along those lines. But the only way to know for sure is to have the actual contract, right? And then that was the deputy sheriff, and then the supervisor is getting paid $49 an hour regular and $64 an hour premium. And then the OIC special events coordinator is getting paid $55 an hour regularly and then $70 on a premium, right? And basically, it looks like he's not paying these people individually, right? Or the money isn't going directly to them. This money is going to the Palm Beach County Sheriff's Office. So this is a program that's basically through the government, right? You know, specifically the law enforcement agency. So I wonder if R. Kelly couldn't have used something like this in his motions. And if I go a little bit further, let me see here. Let me see if I can get to this. So it looks like basically Epstein paid a total of $128,000 for the services that he got from the sheriff's department, right? You know, so the way this works, again, is that it looks like the sheriffs that gave these services to him were off-duty sheriffs, right? But it was through the actual sheriff's office. So going back to R. Kelly, there should be a way, or there could have been a way, or let's just say he could have basically presented to the court. So in R. Kelly's situation, I think he could have engineered something similar whereby he could have paid the sheriffs directly, and basically the off-duty sheriffs could have provided security for him and for the courts to ensure that he didn't violate the terms and conditions of his bail. You know, so the longer he's locked up, the more difficult it is going to be for him to be able to basically fight his case, because you have to do an incredible amount of coordination with your legal team. And the other thing is that he can't appeal to the public, right? You know, because one of the things I would do is the same thing that, you know, the alleged victims are doing and the unseen hand is doing in this case, which is spewing all this stuff out over the internet, and it's mostly negative information. And if he's out on bail, he has the ability to hold regular conferences where he can, you know, make videos, and he can basically come out and he can basically tell his side of the story. And of course, lawyers probably wouldn't want him to do that, but he doesn't necessarily have to tell any specific details. He can just make a general appeal to the public, right? And I think that's why they don't want him out, is because they know that if he gets out, he could basically start talking to the public and explain to the public how this is wrong. And then there's lots that you can, ways you can help your case in the public eye by not giving out details of your case, right? You know, so I think that's why they want him locked up, because the longer he's locked up, the less likely of a chance that he has to basically win this case. That's it for this video. Leave your questions and comments below and let me know what you think.